Hello.
Hey, John. How are you?
What's happening? Come on in. Welcome to the Haven.
So, why are you here right now?
Why am I here? I'm here because Dream Theater is wrapping up our latest record. Been here for 4 months, and we're in the final stages.
What poster did you keep on your bedroom wall during high school?
I do remember having a poster of Iron Maiden when they were at, they were probably at Compass Point. I think it was like they were in the Bahamas and they were like all dressed in summer clothes.
If you could be a rock star from any era, who would you be?
You know what? I've thought about this a bunch that, you know, the style of music we play, the kind of progressive thing, was really big and all over the radio and, you know, really successful in the 70s. So we kind of like were born in the wrong era. So it'd be nice to take this, move it into the 70s, and that would have been pretty interesting.
What is your all-time favorite album?
Oh boy, that's so hard. So hard to choose. I guess I can start with my all-time favorite band, which is Rush. And if I had to pick one, probably Hemispheres from that band. Lots and lots of memories playing that over and over and over and over and just being blown away.
What do you still have from your childhood?
My sense of wonder.
What was your first car?
My first car was some kind of Toyota that my aunt and uncle gave me. That was all. It was very nice of them, but it was definitely pretty beat up.
If you were a pro in sports, which sport would it be?
It would be soccer. I used to be really into that, or for the rest of the world, football. Yeah, my heroes were Pelé and Franz Beckenbauer growing up. I was totally into soccer until I got into music.
What is your favorite place to hang out?
You know, besides home, I'm definitely a homebody. Love hanging out at home. I love the studio. I just love the environment. I love the wood. I love the smell of the coffee machine and gear and just being surrounded by that environment. Just so I can stay in there forever.
Your favorite burger place?
Five Guys. 100% best burger.
Your favorite barbecue place?
Anywhere that Sterling Ball is cooking, because he is a barbecue champion pit master, and I've never tasted barbecue as good as Sterling's barbecue. It's out of this world.
What is your worst habit?
Probably cracking my knuckles. It's probably not good for you.
Best habit?
Best habit? Can't you tell? Probably going to the gym. Sorry, I should do this. Sorry.
If you weren't a professional musician, what would you be?
If I weren't a professional musician, I can't even talk. I had one sip of bourbon, and I can't say professional. Probably something still in the arts. You know, I was for a long time very much into drawing and painting, and I'm into writing and storytelling. So some kind of artistic thing.
How long could you survive in the jungle alone?
About 2 seconds. I'm the wimpiest of wimps. I hate bugs. I need air conditioning. I would be dead within minutes. So, there you go.
Hey James, how are you?
How you doing, bro?
If you had a superpower, what would it be?
Deadpool.
What's your favorite Dream Theater album cover artwork to date?
Well, believe it or not, I think there's two. Scenes from a Memory and Black Clouds, Silver Linings, yeah.
What was the last country you visited?
The U.S. I'm Canadian, right?
What country would you like to visit?
Morocco, yeah.
What's the biggest lesson that being in a band for so long has taught you?
Keep your head on straight and keep everything in perspective. Yeah.
What would you like to be remembered for?
A hockey stick and a hockey puck. No. Anyways, I don't know. I don't know. Hey, I'd like to be remembered for Dream Theater. Absolutely.
What's your favorite U.S. state to vacation in?
California.
The best pizza you've ever had?
Ray's Pizza.
How do you take your coffee?
It's actually not coffee. You don't mind if I walk away from you, do you, right? But I'm going to go sit somewhere more comfortable. It's espresso for me. So an espresso with a tad bit of honey in it. Yeah.
Do you have a favorite pinball game as a kid?
Was never a pinball wizard.
Favorite video game?
Yeah, see, you got me again.
The last book you read?
By an author by the name of Brent Weeks, W-E-E-K-S, and it was called The Black Prism, using colors to give you powers. Yeah.
What's the best parental advice you were ever given?
You know what? Just try and keep it real with your kids and let them know that everyone makes mistakes, but the best thing you can do is go through life and be respectful, you know, and just, yeah, treat others as you would like to be treated. Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, Mike, how you doing?
Twisting things.
How long does it take to set up your largest drum kit?
It takes Eric about 2 hours after everything's in a case and labeled and everything like that. That's what I believe.
Can you describe the drum sound on the new album in one word?
No, but I'll say satisfying and hopeful.
What's your favorite venue to perform in?
Not yet. TD Garden in Boston will be once that happens.
Besides drums, your favorite instrument?
Heaviosity computer-generated keyboard plugins.
What's your favorite movie?
Rock.
Your favorite actor?
Carol O'Connor.
Are you a better golfer than John Mayon?
Well, wait a minute. I got 15 more years experience. So relatively speaking, no. But I will get a lower score. But I should, because I've been playing a lot longer.
For fun, would you rather bike, hike, run, or ski?
Ski.
What's your favorite Disney character?
I'm not aware of a lot, but I'm going to say Happy.
What's your vice?
Sassy, succulent, delicious red wine.
What is the best sporting event you've been at?
Super Bowl 38.
Do you listen to podcasts?
Not yet.
What is the longest you have gone without sleep?
Probably 30 hours.
Your favorite movie quote?
My favorite what?
Movie quote.
Probably from The Martian. When Matt Damon was asked, they wanted to know something about him. He said, all you need to know about me is that everything's going to go south at some point. And if you don't accept it, it's going to get worse, or you can accept it and just start solving one problem at a time, and that's it. Because he was going to die up there. So.
Hey, John, how are you?
Hey, how's it going?
Do you practice your instrument every day?
I attempt to, but it doesn't always happen every day.
What bassist inspired you most significantly?
Oh, there are three. Steve Harris, Geddy Lee, and Chris Squire.
Do you prefer CD, LP, or digital?
Actually, I've grown to love digital because it's so efficient, doesn't take up too much space, and I have everything at my fingertips.
Do you prefer to travel by plane, train, boat, or automobile?
I prefer automobiles.
If you had three wishes granted to you, what would the first one be?
Oh, that's a biggie. And put an end to chaos and starvation.
What musician or singer would you most like to have as a guest on a Dream Theater album?
Really? I don't know. You know who would be really cool? Dave Grohl. He would be awesome.
What's the most unique gift a fan has given you?
Probably a collection of photos that go back 30 years. On my 50th birthday, I was presented with an archive of photos that spanned pretty much every album since Images and Words, and that was a pretty amazing gift.
How many hours of sleep do you need each night?
I try to get as much as possible, hopefully at least 8.
What country would you like to perform in that you have not yet?
The continent of Africa would be cool. We haven't been there yet. It'd be nice to go there.
What's the best method of keeping in touch with family when touring?
Oh, probably text messaging. Global text messaging has made it very easy.
Your favorite subject in school besides music?
Favorite subject? I didn't really have a favorite subject. I went through school with the desire to just get home and start playing bass.
Do you collect anything?
No, I'm not really a collector, other than I have a nice collection of Music Man basses. That's about it.
Are you a better golfer than Mike Mangini?
No, but I'm working on it.
Hey Jordan, how are
you? Hey, what's up? I'm deep in the blues here.
Who's your biggest role model?
Biggest role model, let's see. I've got a bunch of them. All the way from classical role models to rock role models. I would have to say my biggest role model keyboard-wise is probably Keith Emerson.
What's the favorite part of your job?
Playing music, rocking out. I love to tour. I love to go all over the world and interact with fans and meet people, and I find that to be a great privilege.
If you could have dinner with someone dead or alive, who would it be with?
If I could have dinner with someone dead or alive, it would be fun to have a cup of tea or some dinner with Jimi Hendrix. That would be fun. I'm even wearing the shirt to commemorate him.
What advice would you give your 20-year-old self?
Wow, if I could go back and give my 20-year-old self advice, I would tell myself to not worry, to keep practicing very hard, and just to be assured that things were going to work out fine.
What's the best piece of advice you have ever received?
Best piece of advice that I've ever received. I received advice to take care of beyond everything else that I do, to always just really take care of myself and make sure that I was healthy and everything else would fall into place.
What was your first job?
My first job, my first real job, I would say, was working for Korg, the company that makes synthesizers, keyboards, and a lot of other things, as a product specialist.
Did you go to your high school prom?
I didn't go to my high school prom because after 10th grade, I went to a very experimental school, the village school, where they quickly found out that I was a serious classical pianist. So they allowed me to basically stay home and practice piano and focus on that. And ended up going to one of my girlfriend's proms, and that's as close to a high school prom as I ever got to.
What is the first song you remember being obsessed with?
I was obsessed with the Beatles. Things like, I would say maybe like Nowhere Man. And I used to keep a tiny little turntable in my room, and right near where my pillow was and my bed, I had a drawer where I had a drawer filled with Beatles 45s. So at any moment I could take my favorite song, throw it on the turntable, and go nuts.
Your first concert?
My first concert was seeing The Who. They were playing at the Fillmore East in 1969. It was, they were playing all of Tommy. It was extremely memorable because I was a young Juilliard kid, and everybody at that concert was nothing like me at all.
What was the first song you were able to play in full?
First song I was able to play in full? Well, I started playing the piano when I was 7, so the first song I could play in full was probably like Twinkle Twinkle Little Star.
What radio station did you listen to as a kid?
When I grew up, radio was very important. It actually was the reason that I kind of got into like prog and rock, because I used to listen to a radio jockey called Allison Steele, who was called the Nightbird on WFMU, and she used to play like a lot of Deep Purple and a lot of really cool things, you know, just touching on prog, and it really caught my ear. So that one.
What's something that people would be surprised to know about you?
Something that people would be surprised to know about me, that I only come out at night. No, that's not true.
What's your most memorable guest appearance on someone else's album?
My most memorable guest appearance? Probably the one that's coming up. I can't even talk about it, actually, but I'll give you a hint. I just had a really great artist who I played with years and years ago called Vinnie Moore, who's a great guitar player. He played a little bit on my solo album, and I might have returned the favor. And the way that I played on this album is going to surprise a lot of people. It's kind of cool.
Which Seinfeld character are you?
I would be the character that actually, you know, played the that crazy bass sound. I would probably redo it my own way, maybe with Geo Shred.